Hi guys, my name is Ishita. No, I usually do not dress up like this to make my YouTube videos at home. This is a special video where I'm telling you guys about how I draped and styled the triple pallu look that I wore for my brother's wedding. Before I get started on the video, I just want to talk about the look. I think I saw Sonam Kapoor wear a double pallu Abu Jane Sandeep Khosla sari once, and I instantly fell in love with her and the idea of wearing a double pallu sari. I immediately knew that at some point I do want to wear that, and when it was announced that my brother was going to get married, I knew that this was the perfect event to wear that look. We had decided on our themes in advance, so I was actually looking for a red sari with a maroon veil or a matching red veil, but I just couldn't find anything. I knew that I wouldn't find a sari with a veil. I knew that those are two things that I would have to purchase separately, but I just couldn't find the sari in the first place. And that's when my mom pointed out that we had the sari. So this is actually a very old raw mango sari. By the way, all the pieces that I wore for the main event wedding for this look are all old pieces, from the sari to the blouse to the dupatta, the veil, the jewelry. Everything was pre-owned, nothing was new, except I think the shoes and the bag that I was carrying, that was new, but everything else was old. The styling in this video is an accumulation of the things that I've learned about draping and styling from my mom, from the Sabyasachi store, and from whatever I have seen Sonam Kapoor style it. So I think it's an accumulation of all these three things. I really hope you enjoy watching this video. Please do let me know if you do, and feel free to ask me any questions in the comment section below. So without further ado, let's just get started.
So the first step of wearing a sari is to wear your shoes, be it flats, wedges or heels. The reason is so that the length of the sari is in perfect alignment with your heels. The next step is to tie your petticoat. Make sure your petticoat is tied at a proper length. I like to place my petticoat just below my navel. I don't like it too low waist. That's just a personal choice, but make sure that it's tight and secure. The petticoat that I got made for this sari is in brocade. The reason for that being that the sari is translucent and you can see the petticoat through it. I got two blouses made with this look. This blouse is close to the neckline and is backless. You can choose this blouse if you just want to wear earrings and no necklace. However, I went with this one, which has got a sweetheart neckline and is backless with tassels at the back. This sari is from Raw Mango. As you all know, Raw Mango makes plain saris. It does not have any embroidered borders, but I got it made specially for this. When you open this sari and put it against your brocade petticoat, you can see that the brocade pattern shines through the sari, and that's the idea behind using it. So when you start draping the sari, start tucking it in from your right side and tuck it in properly. Keep in mind the length of the sari, the border has to finish right where your heels touch the floor. Tuck the sari all the way through, finishing one circle. Make sure when you tuck it in that it feels tight and secure. The rest of the fabric that is left all the way up to the point where your pallu border starts, you are going to pleat it all up. Hold a small section of the sari between your two fingers and keep making the pleats all the way till the point where your sari is tucked in. After you have finished your pleating, make sure that you secure the pleats properly with the help of a safety pin right at the top. With whatever fabric that is left between the point that you've tucked your sari in and to the point of the pleats, you kind of want to stretch it out so that the sari from the top looks fitted. And then you want to tuck your pleats in. After this step, you should have the border of the pallu starting right where your pleats finish. After you have tucked in your pleats, make sure that you secure it properly with your petticoat with the help of a safety pin from the inside. Now is the time to drape your pallu. You can drape your pallu however. I'm going to take a seedha pallu, which is from my right arm all the way down. I'm going to secure the pallu on my right arm of the blouse and I'm going to adjust the length of the pallu. This is how it should look from both the sides. When you're securing your pallu on your blouse, make sure you put a pin right at the tip of your shoulder in the front and at the back. Now we're going to secure the end of the pallu on the left side. All your safety pins are to be secured from the inside so that there is no pin visible from the outside. Now we're going to identify all the parts that need extra fixing. You can either tuck them in or you can add extra pins to secure it. This is how your saree should look at this point. You can see that the pallu is just hanging on the right arm. It has not been pleated. That's because I intend to keep it like that. And I'm going to secure it with the help of a pin on my arm from the inside. You obviously have to take the help of another person to do this. And this is how your pin arm should look. After this step, you should be wearing all your jewelry. If you're going to layer necklaces, then start by wearing the longer necklace and then the choker. Now you should be wearing your earrings. These earrings, they have a hole for the ears and they have a loop that is to be added on your hair. Now you can move on to other things like your mang tikka. Place it properly right how you want it and then secure it safely with the help of bobbins. Wear all your bangles now. Always start by wearing the bigger bangles first. Does not matter even if it's loose. Just make sure the one which is right in front is to your size. Now you can see the reason why we had pinned the pallu on your arm is so that the pallu doesn't fall over your bangles and your bangles are visible. You don't have to wear the same bangles on both your arms. I'm going to wear different ones on my left arm. Next, I'm going to add only one statement ring on the arm which has lesser bangles. After you have worn all your jewelry, you can wear the nath, which should be the last step. You can see that this look is already starting to come together. The look by far is pretty much a complete look. You don't have to add a dupatta after this. It's completely optional, but this is a finished look in itself. To elevate the look further, you can add a banarsi dupatta on the side. Make sure that you fold the dupatta and take the center of the dupatta to pin it on your shoulder. We're gonna add a pin on the center, in the front and at the back to secure this dupatta. I have pinned this dupatta right on the edge of my shoulder so that my waistline is visible, and now we're gonna pin it right above the bangles, just how like we pinned the pallu. And this is how it should look with the second dupatta on. Now to add the third dupatta, I have chosen this organza dupatta. Whenever you're adding a third dupatta, just make sure that it's of the same color and the similar embroidery as in the rest of your ensemble. For this dupatta as well, we're going to identify the center of the dupatta and pin that on the top of your head. You've reached the finished look now. This is how everything should look. You can take one side of the dupatta on your head in front or you can keep it at the back. This is how it looks when you keep the dupatta of your head at the back. The final edition will be of this potli bag. You're just going to take the strings of it and put it on your wrist. You can also tie it in your wrist if you want. And there you go guys, this is your complete finished look, the triple pallu saree look. You can literally do this with any saree and any dupatta. The only thing that you really have to keep in mind is marrying all these pieces together. And as you know now, it's really not that difficult to put this look together. It's really just about attention to detail. You can wear this look as a bride, you can wear this look for your sibling's wedding like how I wore it. You can wear this later at any point in your friend's wedding. It really all depends on you.
Thank you so much for watching this video guys. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. This is my version of the triple pallu saree. Please do let me know how you like it. Leave your comments in the comment section below. My name is Ishita Mangal and I will see you next time, not dressed like a bride or a semi-bride next time. I promise. Bye.